anybody want the Lord to make him over? Just begin to celebrate Jesus. Hallelujah.
You know my other side.
Hey musicians, how you doing? Sean Wilson here. Today we're going to learn Make Me Over by Tonex. This song was requested about a year ago, so it's been a minute. Should have done it a while ago, but if you're doing this song, if you're going to be working on this song, definitely tag me on Instagram. Let me know. Let me see what you're doing. I would love to see what some of you guys have just working out the song. And let's go ahead and get started, because this song has some kind of some difficult chords there. I want to work out with you, and thanks again for watching it.
I push you out all over the building. Let me hear you say, Lord, make me over.
Okay, so those are the main chords. Okay, so those four chords that forms the motif of the song. Right, and so what we have here is an A flat chord. We have a G flat chord over B flat. We have an A flat chord over C. And then, honestly, you can keep everything just like this and just bring this C to a D flat. One of the things that I talk about in my course as the difference between a beginner and a competent is that you need to be able to know when it's okay to use a seventh chord versus an add two versus just a regular major. So that's a decision that all musicians have to start making. You don't want to just be concerned with notes, because when you're just concerned about what the notes are, you're thinking at a very low level. You're thinking at beginner level. You start moving past beginner level when you're thinking about how those notes are related to each other and how, you know, when you should use what, right? So for this first chord, it is an A flat major chord, but you know, you could make the decision to just keep this regular and not change it because it sounds good as it is. Okay, this next chord here wouldn't do good to add an extension. You know, we always talk about fattening chords up. Sometimes the best fattening you can do is just maybe in many cases just double up on some of these notes, right? Without adding extra notes. And so in this chord here, I wouldn't do much. Now on this chord with the A flat over C, this is a chord that could require another note, right? And the ways that we can extend chords are with the seventh note, which would be a G, with the we could extend with the second note, which is a B flat. Okay, we could even extend it with an F, which is the 13. Okay, the 6 and the 13 are the same, but I would extend this by adding the 2. Okay, so if you hear it with it, then it makes sense, right? See how that sounds? So I think that's the best addition to make for that chord. And then on this chord, it's just supposed to be a D flat chord. But the reason I told you to go ahead and have this as an A flat chord and only move this C to a D flat, because it creates an D major 9. Okay, and so that's a great extension to use for this. So those are the first four chords. So if you play them all, it'll sound like that. And let me just go ahead and play it with them. Okay, and then you may have noticed that right before I hit this, you know, we did, right? Which is a really easy thing. And this lesson is really a beginner lesson because the song is quite simple. Now, let's go to some of the other parts of the song. These are the same chords as Make Me Over are the chords on the verse, so they're all the same. Okay, now hear the next part.
Thought that I had a plan.
Okay, so those next chords there. Okay, so the thought that I had a plan is going to be A, F, let's choose a C, G, C, D, G. Okay, although I like the chord like this as well, but sometimes you can kind of you can do it like that, or you can just hold the G and then just trill from the C to the D. The next chord is going to be it's really a strong E flat chord, because if you hear it when they go, you hear that note there? You hear it? So it's a really an E flat bass chord, so it's kind of like an E flat major chord, but you have a G at the bottom. Okay, his melody line, he's on an F. Okay, so if he's on an F, you hear that strong G, you hear a G at the E flat, and you have the G in the bottom. If you put that up, it implies an E flat major add two. Okay, so that second chord is going to be this, which is an E flat major, right? Add the two, which is the F, put the G on the bottom, and we're adding the seventh because it's part of that chord, right? So it's going to be, okay, that's the way to voice that. And then you have an F, F minor 9, the next chord, which is F, E flat. You can do a G, A flat, C, and an E flat. Okay, let's go up to the next one. Okay, so on this one, so on this chord, it is a D minor 7 chord, and this one is a B flat diminished. What I'm hearing a lot of people play it though, they're playing it with as a whole D. They're playing with an A, and they're playing the diminished with the G. But you don't want to do that, because on this particular voicing, it does not have the A, it doesn't have a G. And if you listen for it, you gotta listen for those notes. See, you hear this strong F there, right? But there's no A. So when you play the chord, you want to play it at the D, F, C. Okay, you have a D and a C at the bottom. All right, and then you have this D flat. Okay, is a diminished chord here. Just don't add the G. Be careful with that. And then you can play this voicing here, which is a C, A flat, B flat, C, E flat, and then go from the A flat to the B flat. And you don't have to do that. You can just go. You can just play it as an A, because it's all, the way you want to play this and the way you want to voice this is really up to you as a musician. You have to make that decision on what you think sounds best. Alright, or that voicing there, you know, there's another voicing that I may like to use. And so this is just B flat, E flat, and G. I went from a B flat chord to an E flat chord. And that replaces this. Let's go to the next one. But the more that you try to be by my side, the more I push you out. Those set of chords are kind of difficult to hear, because there's a note in there that seems off, but you have to get that note. Your ear has to pick up on that note. What you could do is you kind of just sing it, and it'll tell you what it is, because if you listen for it. But the more that you try to be by my side. Da, da. If you listen very closely, you'll hear the organ go. And then you hear it go. That note is really, it's an off note, but it's really key to finding that chord. I want you to listen for that. But the more that you try to be by my side, to be by my side. Play it one more time. To be by my side. You heard it? It's kind of hard to hear unless you are, if you're listening on a phone, it's gonna be hard. So if you have some good speakers or headphones, you kind of hear it better. Okay, but since the melody is going, I'm gonna put that melody with that little off note that I hear. So that's gonna be. And then, right? So though that last set of chords there, those are tritones. Okay, so those tritones give me a hint on what the chords should be. Now, when you're listening to the bass, I know I'm really going into kind of an ear thing here, instead of just teaching, but kind of, I want to teach you as well how to pick up these things, because this is the chords that a lot of people had trouble with. So.
But the more that you try to be by my side, the more I...
Okay, so that bass is going... So I'm going to play the bass with the melody. And then they go back to the, right? So most, a lot of transcription, and this is what I recommend all musicians do, is not just ear. Okay, I would say, yeah, 60-65% ear, but a lot of it is just going to be like a puzzle, like trying to fit in what works. So I have this, I have that, I have the bass note, I have the middle note, so it's just a matter of now putting it all together. So, and why am I playing it up here as opposed to, right, I could play it up here, which sounds nice, but the words of the song as an accompaniment, you know, our job is to make sure that we are fitting the tone and providing support for that message. Right now, it's a bleak message, right? The more that you try. So you want to be dark. And the way to do that is to come to this lower register of the piano and support him. It's a powerful song. And so you want to make sure you're there. Your music is always kind of supporting that. So be down here. See, that sounds really nice dark. So, right? Now, this next chord, oh, by the way, that's going to be C, E, C, D, G, C, D. I would just do this. And then play that melody with your third finger. Don't put any A's in there. This song does not use a lot of fully diminished and fully minor chords. They're leaving off certain notes which are providing a really unique sound. E flat, C, F sharp, and C. And then we go down to D, but because we knew that that tritone, at the time of the D, we had that tritone, that's gonna mean that it's a dominant chord. Okay, because the other tritone was here, at the time that this was a C sharp, that's gonna form a diminished, but without the G, because we've been doing a lot of diminished chords without that second to the top note. All right, so hopefully I'm not going too fast, but you're still getting the notes. I'm just trying to do some teaching and theory at the same time here. Then a D dominant to the diminished. And then this is a B major 7, right? B, E flat, G flat, and B flat. And then you're gonna go to an E, B, F sharp, G sharp, B, D sharp, F sharp. And then I would do that. They don't do that. That's just my way to transition to that. And the thinking of this is this, he's about to hit an A flat chord. So to go from here to here, they have a little transition there. Okay, so let's hear how that sounds. Where am I at? Oh yeah. See, you're going darker and darker, the worst. See, and then you get to the E.
All over the building,
hear you say, Lord, make me over.
See how that works? So it works perfectly. And that's really the whole song. And I want to make sure that I don't forget anything. Yeah. All right, yeah, that's the whole song. All right, you guys, go ahead and learn this song and tag me on Instagram. Let me see it. I love it when you guys learn with me. This is a discovery channel. So that just means that, you know, the things that I find, the things that I transcribe, I share them with you guys. So I like it when we actually not just listen, watch what I'm doing, but go take it home, try to learn it. This is something easy that you could do pretty easily. So it's an easy song, and it's going to help you kind of get some, you know, and some nice voicings too. So thanks again for watching. We'll see you guys later.
Failed you, pierced your side when they already